Sophie. It's also a difficult program. Difficult pieces and very nice, right? DBC was first. Listen, just before we do anything, can I just check one spot? I think you learned something wrong there. Can you play that? Only these four bars. Fix it, right? That's okay. What is this style? Oh, this is Debussy, impressionism, that's right. What does it mean? Yes, so basically composers were trying to express, express what? Yes, 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 but you know that it was interesting because composers, or say artists, before Impressionism, they were trying to express, say, an apple, for example, to paint as true to the apple as possible. During the Impressionistic time style, they have to be also as true as possible, but not so much to that apple, but to their impression of this apple. It's a little bit twisted. Right? On some of the paintings you can see ocean brown. Can be brown, but if an artist feels maybe some in a gloomy mood, ocean can be brown to him. Anyway, so here we can create some clouds with pedal, but we should know where we can and where we can't. We also want some clarity suddenly in the clear spots. Anyway, can you start again? Do we want this cloudy or not? Probably not, right? So what's missing here is probably just, it's a technical issue. You are slightly too soft in your right hand, and it's a bit sloppy, right? You need a bit of a rain. If it's a gardens under rain, it has to. You have to have articulation to express the actual rain. You try? Maybe more even. Okay. Can you play just the first one repeatedly? Don't jump too high. Try to achieve absolutely even. So be, don't emphasize, but be more aware of the top note. And now keep going, play it. And here. Crescendo. Okay. Good. Can you include into this crescendo top note as well? And a bit of pedal as well. And then have the F note a bit louder and then start to play. Then together with the F note decaying, play a little bit of diminuendo then. Articulate. You have to articulate sometimes just better than you do. Also, we have to jump from section to section. If you tell, we'll try it from here. Solution, because what you do, you play from here to here. But what we have this. We have polyphony. Maybe don't put fourth beat. One, two, three, and then more phrasing. Ti-do, ti-do. Clarity purposes, in the right hand, try to react with your articulation to this small crescendos. Now, with the top note, a little bit more. Cheap, if I can put it this way. Yeah, so too simple. Then I don't know it. Too much like a study, because it has more. Like, imagine you have a brush and you paint. You have this. Much more expression together with the right hand, not just left hand. So I can't show it. Try. Yes. Yeah, it's a little bit technical still, but you can work on making this music much more with more harmonics, ups and downs, more breathing, rather than just do. This is what we need at the beginning. That's different. That's here different. It has much more shaping and harmonic beauty. And then, just before I forget, you know this section, right? What's the touch rhythm in the book? How would you call it? Staccato with legato, right? It has a few names. One of them would be portamento, right? The proper execution of this touch is when anything with the dot has to be played, I mean, not 100%, but most of the time, has to be played from the key. The difference is that when you play staccato, you make it sharp. But here, still play from the key, but not sharp. Because what you do, you play actually legato. You play, but it has this breathing, beautiful ta, 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 portamento. Can we try? Da, 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 da. Yeah. You stay more in tempo. It's tempo one, right? Stay more in tempo, but your right hand has to breathe. Do this touch. I think it's a lot better like that. Yes, and you fix this note. Yeah. Now, Chopin, look, you have beautiful qualities here. Your fingers are fast and sometimes very colorful sound in some sections, not everywhere. You know, I think the main thing for you not to start so loud, because this subject, this one in the left hand, has so much elegance. It's much more beautiful. Don't play it loud. It doesn't start forte. Yep, let's start again. Do you really feel this is a big guy with big stomach? Huh? Do you feel like that? Do you feel that? Really? It doesn't feel like this. It's much more elegant. And then, imagine it's a stylish guy. Stylish guy looking, walking on a promenade in Nizza. Do you know what Nizza is? Nice. Anyway, okay, let's start. Just try one more time on the left hand. Try just left hand. clarity on the top note here. Don't overpedal. And also, look, that second finger here, right? For a reason, because if you do it like this, it immediately sounds very heavy and disjoint, because it comes from there. The shaping comes from here. One more time. Yes. So easy to do. Yeah. Make it a bit more beautiful. Don't push. Don't panic. Just play slower, maybe. Then here. What's this? From here to. Think how you shape the whole subject. Your speed for now. It still blows out of proportion. You feel it, right? So maybe at home, look at how you can make this more elegant. One way of doing it, simply reduce the push, so to speak, not so loud. Another way of seeing it also, the balance between hands doesn't sound right to me. How can I put it? When you play Chopin music, maybe this is not the best example, but when you play Chopin music in general, think of this texture as the water. Water just running through landscape, taking different shapes. Because if you do this, there's no water, it's just bricks, rocks. Technically speaking, by the way, the last one. Technically speaking, this music has accents. 1, 2, 3, 4. That actually gives you a little bit of a clue how to play technically, because what you do, you're trying to connect, right? There's no need. Try to make a shift, but nobody should know about this. Play very slowly. Stay in one position, don't move. Yeah, but it should not be looking like a jump. It's a flip. When you turn, that makes the whole music is a little bit disorganized. These accents are not big, they're very small, but they are organizing your music. Ta, ta, ta. Stay in one position. Looks like we have to finish. So there's one more boy.